So Nigel, if you could just start with introducing yourself, like who you are and a little bit about the 9 Miles project.
Oi. So one of my mottos and declarations I live by is that I believe that I have been created for a purpose and that I am perfect for my purpose. And I don't have to measure myself to any person. I don't have to compete with any person, knowing that my very existence here has full potential and passion and purpose to fulfill my destiny in life. And that's one of the things about going the distance with the children. We believe in their success and their growth because we believe every child is perfect for their purpose, that they have gifts and talents that is rare and unique only to themselves, and they don't have to measure themselves with any other youth or any person in the community, because they will always stand out and they will always be number one, because there's no one like them. There is only one of them.
When I go to the seaside, I'm not trying to say that everybody wants to go. I fell in love with the seaside. I handled my charm with time and sleight of hand.
How did I do that? Pepper feet.
I think what's wonderful about building new boards is that it's such a process.
Yeah.
And at each process you learn something about what you're doing and about yourself, and that makes it really special because you're putting a little bit of yourself into it.
You know, the seed, it seems almost impossible to imagine that you take this tiny little seed and you put it in the ground and it sprouts, and these two little green leaves come up, and then this tree grows and grows and grows and grows and grows. It just seems to me that out of nothing, you have this beautiful material that kind of comes out, and it connects us to nature in quite a profound way, I think, that we're reminded of when we look at it. Do you want to go to the seaside? You know, I think we all get this, what we call stoke, that comes out of our experience with the ocean, and it's an energy. It's such a positive energy, and we all have that. You know, we experience it differently, perhaps, but we tend to associate it with the process of being in the water, of catching an amazing wave, and that fills us with stoke, and we feel great, or having a wonderful session. But I think what's really interesting about building a wood surfboard is that you're taking that stoke and you're putting it in a workshop setting, and you're channeling it into the construction of something that involves a whole lot of skills and creativity.
Because when you're in the water, you don't concentrate on what happened at school or what happened. You're just focusing on catching that next wave and doing that turn and doing that cutback.
When you're in the clubhouse here, you can immediately pick up a vibe about what's going down here. You know, it's connected with surfing and life skills and growing people.
If I had to let my circumstances get the best of me, where would I have been? 9 Miles Project has taught me to be a dreamer, an achiever, and to be a leader.
I didn't expect this. I thought it was just a blank Guatimas. But now I see with my eyes. Four different things.
Like a piece of wood. You see, it's good, bro.
So serves up.
But this is different and it's very odd. Ooh. It's the oddest thing ever.
It's hard work.
But it's, now I feel
good. Yeah. Proud of yourself, no?
Yes, all drinks.
Wood is just such a magnificent material to work with. It's just so rich and so ever-changing. And it's almost like you can see in a piece of wood the patterns of nature, you know, like how a tree grew, and its character comes from the seasons that it experienced, and drought, rain, heat, cold. And there's a fascinating connection to the ocean too, because if you look at the grain in a piece of wood, it in some ways mirrors an approaching swell. each of those surfboards, you know, when I look at those surfboards, when I look at Faieq's surfboard, I can see Faieq in that surfboard, and I can see Marcy in that beautiful longboard, and Shannon in her mini Malibu, and Kenzil in the single fin. You know, it's like, it's almost like those boards are infused with a certain personality because of who made them. You can also see how, you know, that tree is it's kind of a metaphor for life itself in a way, because, you know, the sap is reaching for the light, you know, it's kind of seeking, it's really looking for something.
So follow the sun, the direction of the birds, the direction of love. Breathe in the air. Cherish this moment. Cherish this breath. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. A brand new moon, brand new sun. Coming down on you like a heavy weight. When you feel this crazy society adding to the strain, take a stroll to the nearest water's edge. Remember your place. Many moons have risen and fallen long, long before you came. So which way is the wind blowing? And what does your heart say? The wind blows when this day is done.